to Casual Gaming Dad here, and I'm back with some Grim Dawn. You know, I haven't forgot about this game. I know that there's a lot of people who might think that, you know, D2R is just going to completely replace everything else.
As you command.
And I don't think that's the case. I don't think it's true. I do think this game has its place. I've said that many times. And, you know, I'm still going to play it from time to time. Probably not as often lately. I have been playing the D2R beta, and I think that that's very understandable at this time, you know, wanting to play it out, see how it runs. I can tell you that it runs great. I'm actually really looking forward to it. I've said also multiple times that when it does come out that next month that I will be playing that pretty much exclusively in terms of ARPGs for some time. And, you know, that's okay. It doesn't mean this game is dead, that I'm not going to play this game anymore. It just won't for the time being. And, you know, especially if I'm playing with friends, which I do expect to play for our friends. You know, I think, you know, if I had more people to play this game with, that I would play it more. Unfortunately, I do not. And that's just the reality. I think, you know, one of the things I enjoyed quite a bit playing D2R in the beta was playing with people. You know, just getting in that group of party of 5, 6, 7, 8 people was pretty fun. It was pretty nice. You know, it's been a while since I've done that in ARPG, to be honest. Diablo 3, I didn't play too much. I did play with friends, but it was never in large groups, and not consistently. And for a while, you know, a lot on the latter half of the game, when I played, it was just mostly myself. So that's probably a big part of the reason why the game I didn't last as long. But I still played it for 1,000 hours, you know, so, I mean, that's a lot of time. I mean, for a Diablo game, it's not quite, I would say 1,000 hours is not, you know, I'm pressing tab, expecting there to be a mini-map, so used to doing that in Diablo 2, and it's not coming, because there isn't one. You have to do this. Maybe it's for the better because I'm just always clicking that tab, you know. But, anyways, you know, I actually have not tried the Amazon out in D2R. I've tried the Paladin, the Sorceress. I was doing the Sorceress last night. That was a lot of fun, actually. And I have also done the Druid. And I think I'm really looking forward to it. It's gonna be a lot of fun. So, anyways, I think it's time to kill Andariel. You know, level 18. I feel like my damage is pretty good enough. I killed her multiple times in D2R beta. I might play some more D2R tonight. Let's see. We'll see, you know. I might. I've been just trying out classes. I could play a barb. I do like barbarians. I could do the barb. I'm not sure if I'll do the Amazon there too, maybe. You know, if I did, I would play it today and tomorrow. I'd do the barb. And one day in the Amazon. I've just been doing the actual one. The thing is, you know, it's just barely enough to really get a feel for a class. Because, you know, at 18, you get certain skills at, you know, 1, 6, 12, 18, 24, and then 30. So, yeah, I did pretty good damage with the strafe. Gonna be would say just overall, it looks and it runs really great, so I'm looking forward to it. You know, trying to fade. Oh, man, that's a good pickup right there. That shrine, I'm gonna do major deeps right now. Big deeps. All I need is to take out all these guys. Good solid few seconds probably for off me. Use the decoy for that. Hopefully that's enough. We'll see. Shit, wait. She seriously just drained all my mana? She is way stronger in Grim Dawn than she is in Diablo 2. Like, literally no comparison here. Take that. Stay off of me. See how much life she had? Like, seriously. She killed my... Oh my gosh. Guided arrow would be good, you would think, but it's not enough. And it does pretty good damage, it's just...
As you command.
Let's try this again. Goes my mana when she does that. Why were they thinking? Why would they give her mana burn? It's not enough, like, to deal with her? Seriously. How much life did she be generating? Oh my god, she killed it so fast. Gosh, it does like nothing to her. She's got such good defense. Okay, the strafe does more. But, look at this. Seriously. Now, okay, what I need to so difficult. There. That was good. God, that poison is just lingering there. Oh, shit. God dang poison. I just can't get hit by any of the poison, literally. Keep moving. Dang it, she used it. Shit. And what a bitch you are, Dario. Ah, shit. Fast you are, especially for the Amazon. Potion. Okay. Use your poison. Am I out of potions? I'm literally out? Oh my god. I'm dead for sure.
As you command.
Oh, where are you going? Are you kidding me? Yes! Cathan's seal. A boat! two. Okay. Get the hell out of here. I can't believe I ran out of potions. Has that ever happened? In this game, it hasn't. That's a first for sure. That was the hardest. Out of any class I've done, that was the hardest. Let's see. Level 20. Oh, I'm so close to level 20. This is better than what I have. A lot of attack speed. A lot of attack speed. More armor piercing. It doesn't have magic damage. Doesn't have. I mean, it's still higher DPS though, so. This tiny little thing. Oh yeah, the ring! 15 life leap per second. Okay, 3% of that there. Oh. That's definitely better than the health regen. Okay. I'll take it. I'll take it. What do you think, Warif? Did I do a good job? Level 19 now. Oh, I still haven't decided that yet. I don't want to rush that. Dex. Chassis. What do you think, Chassis? Joshy thinks I should sell these things. With a string, you've done me well. It looks like it might be time to hang up the old knockdown. Just go to the L rune again. Do I have another one? Oh, I should go in here. Food ration. Healing potion. I'm out of frickin' healing potions, for God's sakes. Not better than snake core. There's all this jank. Oh, Saigon, I forgot about that. Saigon's 25. I got storm strike. Doubt I have anything useful right now. Let's go to act two. Let's do it. Dang, Andario, what a pain in the ass. What a pain you are. How's the stream doing? Seems a little choppy. Why is it doing that? Hold on a second. Oh yeah. Okay, let's try this. Skip to frame. Let's try this. See if it runs better now. Yeah? You know, it's weird. Like, if I have the browser open with Twitch, it seems to not run as good. If I minimize that and just keep OBS open, it seems to be a little better. Who knew? Alright, let's go talk to Atma, and we'll go down to the sewers. But not before.
I bet you wonder how the.
You
be careful out there.
I hire a desert mercenary. How much gold do I have? Oh, I have enough.
Be careful out there.
Act two mercenaries are good. I can do prayer, defiance, thorns. I can do blessed aim again. I can do might. You know, prayer's pretty good early on. Is pretty good. It's useful. I could do might, but dang, that's really expensive. I have blessed aim right now, which helps a little bit, but you know what? No, I'll just keep this for now, for the time being. I don't mind the blessed aim and the other ranged character. Okay, let's go down to the sewers. Go down. actually important. Go with something like an Amazon. If you miss, doesn't matter how much damage you do. But the thing is I put a lot in dex, so my AR should be good. If you think about it that way, you think, see, like, look at it. A guided arrow just doesn't cut it. You gotta strafe. Only way to do it with DPS. You know, I played Boazons in Diablo 2. Definitely did. But I played more Javazons, so I don't recall. I think strafe was the main go-to. I mean, I know there's multi-shot as well. That's what I did. But I just don't know. Why is it doing that? Just kind of assuming. God, it takes a lot of mana. Just kind of assuming strife was it. You know, it seems to be pretty good. Just DPS, you know, you're just like a little machine gun. I'm gonna have to use potions on me, you know? I only have 10 mana potions left. Is that gonna be an issue? I mean, what's kinda cool in this game is I don't have to carry bolts or arrows. Don't gotta worry about that. Some way to retain mana is gonna be can't rely just on potions. I don't think that's a good idea. I mean, I could, but it'd be better if it was a little more self-sustaining. So, you know, before D2R, this was, for me, the best Diablo 2 experience, and in some ways, it still is. Definitely still is. There's definitely some charm about the original Diablo 2, and they've added some quality of life improvements to the game. Such as the ability to respec, you know, you'll be able to have these direct potions, and you'll be able to do that, and you'll be able to craft them. So you can buy them, like, people can make them, that means they created a market for those, so people are going to definitely buy and use those, you know, trade with, whatnot. You can also do it once per difficulty with Akara. Another way to do it. And I do like that. I think that that's really great. I think especially, I think it's enough, to be honest, that means three per character, just because, you know, while being able to do it freely has its perks, I think there's a little bit of, there's something to be said about the permanency of your choices. There's something about that that's kind of inviting, you know? And in Diablo 3, it was definitely lacking in that. You can just do it at any time. And while I don't mind being able to do it any time here for experimentation purposes, I think if you're being a little more selective and careful with your build, it allows some room for, okay, I'm going to level up in normal with this build, and then once I hit this level, I'm going to change things up. You know, so if I'm a sorceress, maybe I'll start with lightning, which is probably what I'd do. That's what I did yesterday. And then I'd switch to fire or cold afterwards. Because lightning, the charged bolts, works pretty well early on. You know, or whatever it may be. You know, maybe you're a paladin and you want to do more zeal early on. And then later you want to do Fist of the Heavens. Or maybe you want to switch to hammers. Do one or the other, and I think it's really cool that they're finally giving us that option to do that, you know. But this game has a lot going for it in that respect. It's funny, I've rarely ever used that ability to turn the screen like that when I play. So, you know, I think the people making this mod will continue to work on it. It's obviously not done. It's got a lot of great things they've done, they've got going for it. Unfortunately, I do think more attention will be turned to Diablo 2 Resurrected. There hasn't really been a big group of people watching and playing this very much. I play it because I've liked it, you know. And much of the Diablo 2 experience for me was the social piece and playing with others. And if I'm able to do that in Diablo 2, I don't see a big motivation for me to want to continue to play this game as a result. And I think that makes a lot of sense. You know, time is very valuable to me, and I don't have the kind of time I used to have. 20 years ago, you know. So I'm definitely going to be more selective with my time and my choices. That's where I'm at with it. Very fun game. I'm grateful to the people who made this mod and the plus hours I've gotten out of it, which, you know, like I said, for a Diablo game, might not seem like a lot, but for a game, period, you know, it's quite a bit, you know, it's a lot of time, you know. It gave me the best Diablo-ish experience I've had in many years. Me more so than Diablo 3. Again, you know, having people to play with, I think I would have played it more, undoubtedly. I played Diablo 3 more. A lot of that was surrounding playing with people during the seasons here and there, and pushing through that. And, you know, if I had something like that here, Diablo experiences, I put more time into this than Path of Exile, Torchlight, a lot of those popular ARPGs, put more time into this one, and I've enjoyed it more. I also should shout out that no mod for the Diablo 1 experience that I had, which was really, really something. If you haven't heard about that, you don't know what the hell I'm talking about, check out the Hell 2 mod. There's two of mods, they're both made by the same person. I haven't checked it out in a while, but the Hell 2 mod, I tried the first one, and then the Hell 2 mod came out. And the second one is really just a better version of the first. It has more to it. I can't think of a reason why you should play the first one over the second, since the second exists. I would just do that. It's unlike any Diablo 1 experience you could possibly have. It's a great homage to Diablo 1. Oh, there it is. Where is this thing? That was really fun. That was the best version of Diablo 1 that I've played, I feel. And it's very enjoyable. And this is the best version of Diablo 2 that I've played. Of course, pending D2R's full release and playing through that more. But I really feel like they took the best of both sides. They took some elements from Diablo 3. They took the elements from Diablo 2, of course. I think I have to, in the end, agree that with the sentiment that many players played this mod at Christ, I'm gonna die for sure. And that is, wow, wasn't for my, God's sakes. I don't know how I survived that, but I think that this mod would actually be better if it was more pure Diablo 2. So if they took out the Grim Dawn elements, I think there's just too much. The loot table's too big. There's too much going on. And so thing is, though, it's give and take, right? You know, I think the option to have the classes for the Grim Dawn is really nice, great. I haven't actually used them in this mod. I contemplated it with this character, actually. I just thought the Diablo 2 classes were just better and stronger, so, and I just wouldn't be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that in D2R. I'm definitely going to miss that part. Being able to mix two classes is really something. I absolutely love that. I do. And I'm going to miss that. But, you know, my heart always takes me back to Diablo. I really do hope that Blizzard as a company comes back from all the controversy and the challenges they've been having, and they learn and they grow as a company, and, you know, and I'm selfishly saying that, partly because of games like Warcraft to just die out, at least not this way, you know. There's a lot of employees there too, and that would be unfortunate, you know. I mean, I'm sure they could find jobs elsewhere, but that's just hard to start over. There's already people that have left, people have gone, some by choice, some not by choice, you know. And would I survive? Absolutely. Of course I would be. I'd still have lots of great memories and games that I played from over the years from Blizzard, including D2R. But it would definitely, I'd be lying if I said I wouldn't be sad for something like World of Warcraft to die in the way that it is. Sad, broken state. And Diablo 4 would be the hardest for me. It's a game that I really, really want to see successful. You know, it's a game that I want, you know. And if it happens, it happens. If it doesn't, it doesn't, you know. Either way, we'll live on. There's so many great games out there for everybody. There's modding communities. I mean, that's where this game came from, right? You know, so there's something for everybody out there. So at the end of the day, we'll all be fine. We'll all make do. We can't be the ones to have to complain, you know. People would have to start over, right? Got families. Or, you know, have 6 points available. I forgot. I don't know if there was anything I wanted here at the end, so that's why I didn't put more into it. Strafe, just because it's strong. Let's see, what time is it? You know, I've been playing games like this, with the exception of the beta, because I did play that for a couple hours at a time, but pretty short stretches. How long have I been playing? 37 minutes, that's it. God, it felt like forever killing Andariel, that's for sure. Okay, come on in, come on in. Okay. I can see the mana cost for Strafe definitely went up. It's powerful now, holy smoke, it's very strong. Look at this, shredding these guys. But mana intensive. Gosh, what I would do for like a meditation aura now or something. Mana regen, I can't even. Look at this. Look at how it shreds through them. Wow. Like, yeah, Strafe is enough to carry me through normal. Like, easy. Easy. On its own. Of course, I say that, and watch, I get to bosses, and it still takes freaking forever. Well, that's what they do in this mod. They make the bosses really difficult. You know? I mean, Path of Exile is the same kind of thing. Okay, are we, You guys. I need to get these line these guys up so I can just pummel through them and use my mana efficiently. Use guided arrow a little bit more just to finish them off. Or something. Gosh, you know, is it really better? Like, apparently it is. More attack speed. The resist, I guess, is good. The attack rating. The damage is just higher. It's just, man, like, it has also pretty good attack speed. And pretty high damage there, not gonna lie. Look at that. Get obliterated. These guys. Our buddies. We'll find out when we get to Radovan. Get to him. level 3. Finally! Where are you, Radamant? What's interesting is I noticed that. Okay. So the other bow was shooting magic arrows. This one is not, and it seems to be splitting a lot more with the strength. Like, it's just doing better. Like, it's hitting everything everywhere. Gosh, our combat shrine. That is weird. So it's just this bow is better in every way. It just feels a lot better to me. I feel like I'm hitting things more. It's just splitting and going everywhere. Likey, that's me. Shoot, can't go that way. Or this way. Wow. Feels like I leveled up pretty quick there. Leveled up twice down here? Stronger, so I don't have to use, even though it costs more mana, I don't have to use it as much. Alright, Radamant, let's find you. Where are you? And see, that's another thing. Like, in this game, you get more skill points to work with and experiment more. Diablo, you're gonna max out. Am I out of potions again? God dang it. Am I out of potions again? Okay, I got one. You know, you're gonna max out 4 skills. And that's it. Realistically, that's what you're doing. You're doing 4, you pick 4, and that's it. And usually, you'll have a main skill, like Blizzard, for example, and it has 3 synergies, so if you really want to max it out appropriately, you're going to do Blizzard and those 4 skills, and that's it. And then you can get a point here or there, otherwise, because you get some from, not just from leveling, but also from quests, you know, each difficulty. This quest. Right. You know what? I can make a portal in case. Is that the only 2 places you get actual skill points? Of course, he's got a crap. easier to dodge your slow ass little star thingies in front of me. And you're still taking a while, but you will die. Here. Here, why don't you chew on that for a little while? Chasing me down. Oh, I got a mana potion. Okay, good, 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 good. Get the you know what out of here. Definitely an improvement. Definitely not. I forgot Gorford gives me mana leech. That's probably why guided arrow is not an issue to use. But strafe costs too much. What am I doing? That's what happened. I got confused because I turned the screen and I was like, huh? There. And my orientation was off.
They say that the deep.
Funny, I actually have two pieces of the set. Not bad. Thank you. or lose it. The one thing I was kind of down about was you can't use items on your followers. I liked that. I did. But I kind of understand why. They buffed them quite a bit. Okay. Figured, what the heck, just put these things in there. Might as well use them, that's the thing, one thing. It's, you always say like, oh, I'll wait, and then you end up not using them, so just use them now, make your life a little easier, make yourself a little stronger. You can get like dodge, avoid, evade, pierce, penetrate, critical strike. Like, these are all really, really good. You know, even inner sight. You know, and then you can use guided arrow scales. Really nice. It's got crushing blow. I would just say max these two out. This may be for bosses, this for clearing things, you know. And I feel like it's better than multi-shot. Maybe even the decoy. Max it out. Yeah, that's probably what I'd do. Anyways, thanks for joining me today. I'll see you when I see you. Have a good afternoon.